Hey, lovely formulators, DIYers, and skincare creators. Today, I'm sharing a water-based gel formula using a natural ingredient called Bakuchiol oil. And it's considered a natural alternative to retinol that can be super irritating to some folk. And later on in the video, we'll talk about a super important additive that you'll want to use to prevent your serum from turning dark. I designed this to resemble a milky white serum, and to keep it white, we'll need to use this ingredient. First, I measure out 81.35 grams of distilled water. Then I weigh out 1 gram of sepimax din. This is going to give us our gel consistency. And also, for the love of everything holy, please use a respirator when you're measuring out this ingredient. I transfer it over to the beaker that has the water in it. And then once I do that, I'll stir it up and get it wet. And after I stir it up, then I'll get out my little, I've just bought this little mini mixer thing. I'll get out my little mini mixer and I'll mix it around for 2 or 3 minutes, let it sit for a minute. That's just so this doesn't get so hot. And then stir it like this for about 10 minutes. And we'll let this sit to the side for just a little bit while we get the rest of our ingredients ready. Next, I'll take another beaker and I'll measure out 10 grams of geranium rose hydrosol. This is thought to bring balance to the skin. It's also thought to calm red, irritated, and inflamed skin. Plus, it feels cool and tingly. Next, I'm getting ready to measure out another ingredient that we need to use a respirator with. This ingredient, I promise you, if you don't have a respirator on, you are going to regret it. It is called sodium phytate. It is the chelator, which means that it binds trace metals like copper ions or iron. And Lushen Crafter suggests using EDTA or sodium phytate when you're using Bakuchiol oil to stop the discoloration. So this will keep our formula that milky white color, but it also does some other things as well as a bonus. It helps to boost the preservative that you're using. It also has skin benefits. It helps lighten the skin, improve elasticity, and it moisturizes. Then I weigh out 0.20 grams of allantoin in the same beaker with the rose geranium hydrosol and the sodium phytate. Remember, allantoin is an anti-irritant. And this allantoin that I'm using is nature identical, yet it is chemically synthesized. Then I measure 2.5 grams of niacinamide. This is shown to help with hyperpigmentation and skin texture. Then I mix this around for a minute and then I set it aside and I begin to measure out 1 gram of MCT or mid-chain triglycerides. Then I weigh out 0.25 grams of Bakuchiol. Then I move both of these beakers over to a double boiler and I bring it up to about 130. And this is because I want the allantoin heated up so that it doesn't turn into shards later on once I do the mixing. So I go ahead and I mix in the ingredients into the gel that I had created earlier. And using my little mini mixer again, that is just the cutest little thing. And then you'll see here shortly that I'll change over to a higher sheer because this gel was just too thick and I wanted more of a milky gel consistency to it. My thought is using the high sheer mixer is that it would break the gel, which it did. It finally got to more of a milky consistency. And you can see I had to change over to another beaker because my high sheer mixer would not get into that smaller beaker. Can we say rookie mistake? So anyway, here we go. I'm going to go ahead and mix this up a little bit until it gets the consistency that I like. Now I'm adding my tocopherols I'm adding 0.10 grams. Next, I add 0.40 grams of liquid germall plus the preservative. And then I go in and I mix it just a little bit more. I measured the pH of this formula and it was about 7.4. And when I put in just a couple of drops of the citric acid, it brought it way down under 6. It brought it to like 3.9 or something. So I had to bring it back up. And I finally got it to a 6.3. And with the niacinamide, it needs to be around 6. So the final pH of this, once I adjusted it, was at 6.3. And what I'm showing you here is that this is very liquidy. It's not really like a full-blown gel, like an aloe vera gel or something like that, that is very fluid. Now, I put this into a clear glass jar, but don't do this. They recommend, or Lotion Crafter, this is where I got most of my ingredients, recommends that it goes into a dark colored container. I guess amber or blue or the greens would work. But I just wanted to see the color that this turned out, and that my aim is to keep it this color. So while I was researching my ingredients on Lotion Crafter, they suggested that you use the sodium phytate to prevent colorization. So I thought this was a great little tidbit of information and I wanted to share it with you guys. If you learned anything out of this video, I sure had a great time making it. Like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you next time. Bye.